I may never march in the infantry, ride with the cavalry, shoot the artillery. I may never fly over the enemy, but I'm in the Lord's army. I'm in the Lord's army. I'm in the Lord's army. I may never march in the infantry, ride in the cavalry, shoot the artillery. I may never fly over the enemy, but I'm in the Lord's army. I'm in the Lord's army.
Yes, sir.
I'm in the Lord's army.
Yes, sir.
I may never march in the infantry, ride in the cavalry, shoot the artillery. I may never fly over the enemy, but I'm in the Lord's army. I'm in the Lord's army.
Yes, sir.
I'm in the Lord's army.
Yes, sir.
I may never march in the infantry, ride in the cavalry, shoot the artillery. I may never fly over the enemy, but I'm in the Lord's army.
Lord's Army, do we have a scripture?
Sir, yes, sir.
I can't hear you.
Sir, yes, sir.
We'll be coming from Psalm 150, verse 1.
Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in his mighty heavens.
Very good. Who has verse 2?
Praise him for his powerful acts, praise him for his abundant greatness.
Very good. Praise God. Verse 3.
Praise him with the blast of the ram's horn. Praise him with the harp. And Lear.
Amen. Who has verse 4?
Praise him with the tambourine and dance. Praise him with the strings of and flute.
Verse 5.
Praise him upon the loud cymbals. Praise him upon the high sounding cymbals.
Amen. And verse 6.
Let everything that has breath, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Very good, Lord's army. So, on the command to fall out and fall in, I want you to fall out and fall back into your marching formation. Fall out. Forward. March. Left. Left. Your left. Left. Your left. Mark time. March. Group. Halt. Fall out.
Praise the Lord, everybody. We're in the army now. We are soldiers of the Lord, and we are fighting for eternal life. Amen? Amen. To God be the glory. I want to thank you, St. Stephen, for coming to worship the Lord with the youth today. You know, it's a great thing to be in the service of the Lord, and we're passing the mantle to our young people. Amen? Amen. That is our duty, to pass the mantle on. We can't keep the mantle all our lives. We got to pass the mantle on. Amen. Let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise for our young soldiers this morning fighting for the Lord. Amen. Their theme this morning is be strong and courageous. And as we go down in the scripture, it said be strong and be very courageous. And we know we need that. Amen. In our carnal self, we know how to be strong. But in our spiritual self, we need to know how to be strong and continue to fight the fight of faith. Because we can't quit. We have to stay on our faith journey. This is the faith journey. Good morning, soldiers. One thing I noticed, you know how to follow instructions. Amen. And one thing school always tell us, that if you want to pass, follow the instructions. If you follow the instruction, you will be victorious. Amen? Amen. Amen. So this morning, are we ready for worship, Sister Holmes? We ready to start our worship? Amen. Let's put our blessed hands together for the Lord today. Amen, amen, amen. Yes. And our worship leader this morning is our youth fellowship president, Brother Elijah Preezy. He's going to take it on from this time forth, and I'm going to sit down and enjoy the young soldiers so I can get some of my moves back, because I'm marching out of step. Amen? Amen. Let's give Elijah a hand as he come forward.
The grace of the Lord be with you. The risen Christ is with you.
Praise the Lord.
We will now have an opening song by the children and youth choir.
Thank you.
not afraid.
I am a child of the King.
I am a child of the King. So who shall I fear?
Shall I fear?
I'm a child of the Most High King.
Of the Most High King.
Of the Most High King.
When the storm cloud rises and the billows start to roll,
I know that I am not alone. I know that God is in control.
When I walk through the valley and it may be dark and cold,
when your staff is near me, struggling all the food bowl.
So who shall I fear?
I know that I am not alone. I know that God is in control.
When I walk through the valley and it may be dark and cold,
the wind is staff is near me, sucking all the food.
We will now have the prayer by Caleb Holmes.
Let us bow our heads. Dear God, please give us strength when we are weak, love when we feel unloved, courage when we are scared and afraid of our surroundings, wisdom to make the right choices. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Amen.
We will now have a scripture by Deonie Fields.
Yes.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
The scripture I will be reading will be coming from Joshua chapter 1, verses 3 to 6. Every place that the sole of your feet will tread upon, I will have given to you, just as I promised Moses. From the wilderness and this Lebanon, as far as the great river, the river of Euphrates, all the land of the Hittites to the great sea towards the going down of the sun shall be your territory. No man shall be able to stand before you all the days of your life. Just as I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I will not leave you or forsake you. Be strong and courageous, for you shall cause these people to inherit the land that I swore to their fathers to give them. The word of God for the people of God.
We will now have a praise dance by St. Stephen Praise Dance Ministry.
Strong, so your back makes you bigger. Thank you, Denasia Fields.
We will now have an offering by Olivia Goodwin.
Stephen Church family. Here in person and virtual, also welcome visitors and friends. We invite you to tag, like, and share with Facebook our worship service this morning. Intercessory prayer every Tuesday morning at 8 o'clock a.m. via conference call. Word Lovers Bible Study every Wednesday via Zoom at 7 p.m. Great news. We can now resume the altar flowers for first and third Sundays. Please see Sister Holmes for your designated Sunday. Today is the final day to get a ticket to the gospel program today at St. Paul Baptist Church at 4 p.m. If you would like to get a free ticket, please see me at the end of service. On behalf of ACES, we would like to thank everyone who attended the Back to School event on last Sunday, but Zoom. The speaker did an amazing job. Special thanks to Miss Amanda Faircoles, Dr. DeBetta Smith, and Mr. Chase Donaldson. Wisdom members will meet on Monday, August 14th at 4:30 at the church. Mount Zion United Methodist Church will be having a Summer Revival, Sunday, August 13, 2023 at 6 p.m. Guest preacher, Reverend Angela. Monday, August 14 at 6:30, guest speaker, Reverend Kenneth. And Tuesday, August 15, 2023 at 6:30, guest preacher, Kenneth Carter. St. Stephen's United Methodist in Faith will be having a conference September 15 through 17. In addition to online registration, there will be printed registration forms provided by Ms. Abram. Attention, St. Stephen's. Our 154th church anniversary is on the horizon. This year's theme is Faith. The door that opens closed minds. The dates are Saturday, October 14th, which will rekindle our Friends and Family Day, and Sunday, October 15th, our celebration will be during worship service. The categories are listed on the card that finance has provided for the occasion. Please see one of the ushers if you have not received yours. You are welcome to pay in installments now until December. Please see any member of finance, Miss Cynthia Green. And happy birthday to all born in the month of August. Happy birthday to our wisdom members, Miss Deborah Myers, who celebrated 72 years on yesterday, August 12th. Please keep our sick and shut-in members in your prayers and all families who are experiencing bereavement. Announcements for Sunday, I'll text if anything else comes in.
We will now have the offering by Olivia Goodwin.
Amen. Good morning. As we prepare to give our tithes and offering, the Bible says in Luke chapter 6, verse 38, give, and it shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down and shaking together and running over shall man give into your bosom. For with the same measure that ye may fall, it shall be measured to you again. Raise your tithes. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you for providing for us and seeing to our needs. We thank you for life, health, strength, and we certainly thank you for all your wonderful blessings. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
We will now have The Purpose by Aiden Pepper.
Good morning. The purpose for our Youth Day service is to alert us that there will be challenging times. We will face difficult situations. We will have to make important decisions. And in all of this, we are to be strong and courageous and keep our hope and faith in the Lord Jesus. And we will be more than conquerors.
Amen. One more thing. Excuse me. So Preston reminded me that Mr. Adam's birthday is today, and Preston's birthday is tomorrow. And I also want to thank everyone for going to my baptism yesterday. It was a good experience, you know, I loved it. But I just want to say thank you, and thank you for all the wishes, and thanks for everything.
All right. We will now have another selection by the Children and Youth Choir.
Amen.
All I can say is God is in the building.
Oh, yes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Before I proceed, I don't think I sent this to Nala, but if you desire to purchase a t-shirt for the women's conference, the deadline is today. So please see Sister Anna Joanne Abram if you desire to purchase a t-shirt for the women's conference. We do want to support that effort. Thank you.
Better when you smile, so smile.
feel like a cold night.
Today's a new day.
Tell me, where are my blue skies? Where is the love and the joy that you promised? And tell me it's alright. I almost gave up, but a power that I can't explain fell from heaven like a shower now.
God, and let me do this before I get in real, real, real big trouble. Y'all see some new faces on the choir? They belong to me. I'm just kidding. They do belong to me, but you know, they're not my children. They're my brother and sister kids. Let's give a round of applause for coming on to the choir, Sister Kadacia Pepper. Stand. And Brother Aiden Pepper, Joseph Aiden Pepper. Stand up, nephew. Stand up, boy. See, that's what I mean when I say my child. Stand up. Yeah, those are our babies, and we're so proud. They came on, you know, they dad, you know, you got to know how to work things. You know, their daddy came on, and he said, you think I need to bring the kids with me? I said, yeah. You need to bring them right with you, and they hear y'all. So let's give God the glory, and we pray, even though if they may not, you know, whatever, we pray that they're here, and we pray that they continue, because they have beautiful voices. To God be the glory.
We will now have the message by Reverend Carter.
I am. Good morning. I am overwhelmed by the presence of the Lord, and God's presence in these people, these soldiers. I am overwhelmed. I am emotional about what's going on. Beautiful, 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 beautiful service. Yeah. wonderful. I don't want to mess it up. Amen. To the singing and I guess the devotional and Mr. Pepper, amen. And the army. Overwhelming. The sister with the worship, praise, the dance. Hallelujah. Glory to God. If you don't sense God in all of what has happened and is happening, amen. You need a refill. Amen. To Terry Carter for having the idea for causing this to happen. Amen. And good job, Miss Carter and Miss Holmes. You're doing a fantastic job with these children. Amen. And I don't think I'll get in trouble saying that this is the best choir in the church. I don't think I'll get in trouble for that. They just mess up my heart every time. Amen. It's a beautiful thing to see these wonderful people. Amen. The folk that were, the young people that were baptized on yesterday. Kayshawn Ryan, God bless you, he's here. And amen. Amen. Nyla Holmes, God bless her. That's, I call her Latrina too. Amen. Just like her mama. And then the preacher, Caleb Holmes. I call him the preacher. Amen. The preacher, the professor. Amen. God bless you all. So, Miss Wright, I'll get those names to you. Yes, ma'am. Thank you. Amen. Bless you. And all the family that attended on yesterday, God bless you. Amen. This is beautiful. I don't want to mess this up. This is so good. I'm serious about that. I'm emotional now. As they say back in the day, I is a man, but I'm emotional today. Praise the Lord. Let me get busy. I'm gonna see if I can keep it straight here. Isaiah chapter 54, verses 1 through 6. Isaiah 54 verses 1 through 6. To Reverend Abram, Mrs. Abram, to Reverend Nichols, to Minister Clement, to Evangelist Staley, to any other minister that may be in the house today, God bless you. Isaiah 54, verse 1 through 6, and it says out of the King James Version, sing, O barren, thou that didst not bear, break forth into singing and cry aloud that thou that didst not travail with child, for more are the children of the desolate than the children of the married wife, saith the Lord. Enlarge the place of thy tent, and let them stretch forth the curtains of thy habitations. Spare not, lengthen thy cords, and strengthen thy stakes. For thou shalt break forth on the right hand and on the left hand, and thy seed shall inherit the Gentiles and make the desolate cities to be inhabited. Fear not, for thou shalt not be ashamed, neither be thou confounded, for thou shalt not be put to shame, for thou shalt forget the shame of thy youth and shalt not remember the reproach of thy widowhood any more. For thy maker is thine husband, the Lord of hosts is his name, and thy Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel, the God of the whole earth, shall he be called. And last verse says, for the Lord has called thee as a woman forsaken and grieving spirit, and a wife of youth when thou wast refused, saith thy God. Amen. I want to focus on verse number 2 and 3. Enlarge thy place, the place of thy tent. Stretch forth the curtains. Strengthen thy stakes. Break forth on the right and the left. And I want to use for a subject. Stretch your expectations. Stretch your expectations. Amen. Stretch your expectations. Amen. It is quite obvious that the world has stretched itself out of control. We're living in chaotic times, and the world seems to have stretched itself in many ways, whereby we are in challenges, economical challenges that have stretched the cost of living. We are being pushed and stretched by political pressures that have stretched unfairness, inequality, injustices, even to the point of cover-up incriminations. Society has stretched itself beyond the common morals of life to the point of corrupt immoralities of our living. Yeah, we have stretched ourselves even in the areas of cultic mentalities and philosophical ideologies and ideas that have stretched themselves into the minds of many, causing folk to act crazy, think weird, amen, say strange, bizarre stuff, confused imagination supported by demonic forces. And so we are in a stretching period, amen. And with all of the stretching that is going on, the stretching of unrighteousness that's going on, stretching of abnormal behaviors that are functioning in our society, the church then, out of all the stretching that is being done, the church needs to stretch itself.
Yes, we do.
Amen. To match and maybe to go beyond the stretching that's going on in our society. The church needs to stretch itself. Amen. Amen. And we must stretch ourselves in carrying out. We must stretch ourselves in carrying out the righteousness of the Lord. Amen. The church then can no longer afford to be laxed in its spirit, lazy in its action, and lackadaisical in its intention. Let me say that again. The church cannot afford to be laxed in the spirit of the Lord. Amen. Lazy in the action of itself, and lackadaisical in its intentions. Amen. We must stretch ourselves to be better. Amen, 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 amen. In our text, God sends a message to Israel by the prophet Isaiah, the 8th century prophet. And the message God sent to Israel was a message of faith and a message of hope. God wanted Israel to have faith and to be hopeful about its future. It was a message of encouraging and a message of enlightening to Israel. Amen. That they should discover who they are.
Oh, yeah.
Discover who they are and whose they are. Every now and then we should discover who we are. Amen. Because you're not finishing. You have not finished discovering yourself. For as long as you live, you will have new discoveries of yourself. Amen. And then we should also discover and remind ourselves of whose we are.
Amen. I make my declaration today that I belong to the Lord. Amen. Praise God. I'm all his. I'm yours, Lord. Everything I am, everything I'm not, everything I got belongs to the Lord. I belong to the Lord. I love God. I love Jesus. I love the Holy Ghost. I love the Word of God. I love the people of God. I'm yours. I'm all in. Praise God. The message from God was a message of future prosperity and success. And we see it over here. These people are our future, and they are God's prosperity. They're going to be successful because they're in the kingdom. And so today we need such messages to all believers and to the church. And so God ensured Israel their blessing, and he ensures us as the new Israel, the church, amen, of our blessings. All the promises of God are yes and amen in Christ. If you're in Christ, the promises will be fulfilled. All of them are yes and amen. Doesn't matter who says no. God says yes. I believe that, praise God. Doesn't matter who tries to negate that, praise God, or who tries to downtrodden that, or amen, berate that, praise God. God says yes in Christ. And the amen is, it is so. The amen is, it's going to happen, amen. The amen is the confirmation and the affirmation of the promises of God. I believe that with all my heart. The Bible says Jesus came that we might have life and have it more abundantly. Praise God. And we can claim that. You got to claim it, amen. Because the world and the devil are working, amen, to make you disclaim that or try to not live it, praise God. But God says we can do that in Christ. And so one of the things that I want us to understand, the first thing I want us to understand is about stretching your expectations. That's what I want to talk about. Stretch your expectations. That's what I want to talk about today. Amen. Stretch your expectation. What is it that you are expecting of yourself? And what are you expecting from God? What do you expect God to do? You think, some people think that God just sits in heaven and be God and be holy and be all of that, but God has an expectation of us. Amen. The Bible says he has given us everything we need for life and for godliness. So we have what it takes to meet the expectations. So the first thing I want us to understand out of this text is stretch yourselves beyond yourselves. Stretch yourselves beyond yourselves. Scripture tells us that the Lord told Israel, break forth. Enlarge the place of thy tent and let them stretch forth the curtains of thine inhabitants. Spare not, lengthen the cords and strengthen the stakes. In other words, stretch yourselves beyond yourselves. Move your expectations beyond your limitations. Amen. What's limiting you? Can you imagine yourself beyond where you are? St. Stephen?
Yes, sir.
Can you imagine yourself beyond your limitations? Can you move your limitations out of your way to get to your expectations? Uh-huh. What do you expect of yourself? Amen. These words that God gave Israel are words of capability. God don't tell you to do anything, amen, that you're not able to do. So he tells them to stretch yourself, strengthen your stakes, move beyond your limitations. And God expects us to do the same thing, praise God. What is it that you think that God wants you to do? God was saying to Israel, you can do more than what you're doing with yourself. I like to make that personal, amen, in our lives. You can do more than what you're doing with yourself. You can improve your own self. Amen. God was saying to Israel, you can be better than what you're being. Praise God. St. Stephen, you can be better than what you're being. You've been told that over and over. Amen. And it is true. Praise God. So we must stretch ourselves to do better and to get better and to even act better. You got to stretch yourself, amen, beyond your own selves. Praise God. Where is it that God wants you to go and do? In other words, God was saying to Israel and even to us today, get beyond the customary. Get beyond the normal. Get beyond the traditional. Yeah, get beyond the usual. Get beyond the ordinary. In other words, God doesn't want to work in the routines of ourselves, but he wants to do something, amen, to challenge him so he can challenge us to get beyond, amen, the practical practices of programs. What is it that God wants you to do? And stretch yourselves beyond your present attitudes and behaviors. And God is saying to us today, praise God, can you get past yourself? Can you get past your pride? Can you get past your pouting? Can you get past your pitiful self? Can you get past, praise God, your finger pointing? In other words, the only way you're going to get to your expectations is you got to get past yourself. You got to get past your proud self, your arrogant self, your big-to-do self, your somebody self, your important self. God is saying to us, you got to stretch yourself beyond yourself. Praise God. He's calling the church today that is in a stretching society to stretch his own self beyond the marginal and the minimal and the minuscule of his habits of practicing the things that are ineffective to get to your maximum. God is saying, stretch yourself beyond the minimum to get to your maximum. Even the army got a slogan, be all that you can be. And what do you think God is saying to the church? Church, be all you can be. Do all you can do. Praise all you can praise. Worship all you can worship. God Almighty. God is saying, I'm telling you, if the army can say that, be all you can be, he's calling the church to do the same. After you stretch yourselves beyond yourself, you got to stake your claim. You got to get past yourself. And when you get past yourself, stake your claim. Declare your territory that you've gained in life, that you gain in yourself. Stake it, praise God. Put the stakes deep down where you have claimed, praise God, your territory. Claim your territory and don't let the devil have it back. Don't let your enemies have it back. Don't let your friends have it back. Stay there and keep pressing forward. Don't look back. Keep marching up the King's highway. Go ahead and reach for the goal. Go ahead and reach for the side. Don't give up your territory. You got to say to yourself, praise God, I shall not be moved. When you get past yourself, don't go backwards. Stake your claim, strengthen your stakes, and declare to yourself, I shall not be moved. The Bible says we ought to be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bring forth its fruit in due season. Praise God. You will recognize that you have, amen, stretch yourself when you walk in the blessings of the Lord. I wish I had a long time to preach, but you realize you've stretched yourself when you don't let everything and anything bother you. Can I talk to anybody? You stretch yourself when they talk about you and it don't matter anymore. You stretch yourself when you learn to let go the petty stuff. Can I get a witness in here? You stretch yourself when you learn how to overcome your obstacles and the oppositions in your way. You know you've stretched yourself. Praise God. Stretch yourself. Stretch yourself beyond yourself. Stretch your faith beyond your fears. What are you afraid of? I'm talking about the church folk now. What are you afraid to do? What are you afraid to leave? Why are you afraid to go beyond what is? Amen. Stretch yourselves, amen, to doing to get beyond your doubts. When you do stuff, your doubt disappears. But if you are not doing what God wants you to do, doubt is in the way. Stretch your hope beyond your hindrances. What do you hope God will do for you? Stretch your purpose beyond your preventions. What's preventing you, amen, from reaching your expectation? Praise God. Second thing I want us to understand is to stretch your boundaries to get to your blessings. Amen. Stretch yourself beyond yourself. You got to work on yourself. Praise God. Don't be pointing at nobody else. Don't worry about nobody else stretching, and whether they ain't stretching, you stretch. Praise God. Beyond yourself. Then stretch your boundaries. Amen. To get beyond your blessings. Praise God. Too many folk have limitations and boundaries within themselves. They have a lot of I will not, I am not, I should not, I cannot, and I do not. Amen. In them. Boundaries. Amen. Don't be, amen, too much into yourself. Don't be conceited and self-righteous. Amen. To think that the world turns around you. Amen. Don't be so important and so handsome. So pretty. Amen. Don't be so neat. Amen. Don't be so organized that God can't use you. Huh? Amen. Don't be so uppity that you can't come down to other folk level. Can I talk to anybody? You may not like this kind of preaching, but that's all I got for you today. Stretch yourself beyond the boundaries you got in you. Got too many I can'ts. Praise God. You got too many I ain't coming. Amen. You got too many I ain't going. Got too many we shouldn'ts in the church. God says, he said to Israel, for thou shalt break forth on the right hand and on the left hand. In other words, God was saying, your blessings are all around you, but you got to get beyond your boundaries. Lord have mercy. In other words, God was saying, don't stop your own self. I'm making a way out of nowhere for you. Trust me, praise God. I can do what you think I can do, but you got to break the boundaries in you. You got to get past your own laws and limitations. You stop in your own self. You're in your own way.
You aggravating your own self. Y'all blocking each other. That's what God is saying. I'm saying to St. Stephen, you might be blocking your own self. Ain't nobody stopping you but you. There ain't no law against us to do good, to do right, to expand ourselves, to develop our own expectations of our own self. Ain't nobody telling you not to. Somebody is stopping somebody. Stretch yourself. Move your boundaries out of the way. And God is encouraging, he was encouraging Israel to grow yourself. Grow yourself. Not only grow yourself, but move toward your prosperity. Not only move toward your prosperity, but move into your privileges. Not only move into your privileges, but move into your power. Praise God. Let me pause and say, I ain't preaching for nothing. Grow yourselves. I ain't going to take too much of your time, but let me tell you, you don't grow without commitment. One of the impediments of church people is that they're not committed like they used to be. One time, we didn't have to tell people to come to church. Praise God. Church was full and packed. Amen. People came to church. Praise God. That was automatic. It was the top of the agenda of life. Praise God. We had to come to church. And we were told to come. Amen. Praise God. And thank God we listened. Amen. If you don't come and you don't grow yourself, you're going to mess up your prosperity, forfeit your privileges, and lose your power. Break your boundaries to get to your blessings, and our blessings are beyond the boundaries of ourselves. You don't get the blessings of the Lord until you break down your boundaries in you. You got to stop being important to you. Amen, amen. You got to stop thinking it's all about you. It ain't about you. Everything ain't about you. Praise God. I'm talking about individuals. Praise God. It ain't about you. It ain't about Carter. Glory to God. If church was about Carter, you got a pitiful church. If church was about you, the church pitiful. Everybody in here pitiful. Praise God. You might be fronting today, but tomorrow sometime, one day next week, you're going to be pitiful about something, sorrow about something, sad about something, down about something. If the church depended on you, the church would be in a mess. But guess what? It is dependent on all of us together, not individually. Praise God. Too often we allow the boundaries we develop to dictate our progress. Boundaries dictate the progress. Shouldn't be. Boundaries can be the trust of traditions and rather than the trust of truth. Trust in traditions rather than trust in truth. Jesus told the scribes and the Pharisees, you have made the commandments of God of none effect by your tradition. Your traditions are in your way. Now, let me say this, that some traditions can be boundaries that block the blessings of the Lord, but there are some traditions that are good. Don't throw all of them. Amen. Weed the ones out that doesn't agree with the word of God. Amen. Patterns and routines can be boundaries that prevent blessings. Patterns. Don't be a predictable church. People don't come to predictable. That's why they can time you. Yeah, they time you. People time you. They says devotion starts about 10. I'll get there about 10, 15, 10, 30. Timely. Yeah. The preacher's going to get up around about 10 to 11, 11 o'clock. That's when I'll come. They're going to take up the offering around about such and such time. I'll come after that. Predictable. We're predictable. Oh, the service today. You couldn't predict this. There you go. Praise the Lord. I love it. Amen. I love it. Amen. And one thing that the devil wants us to do is to continue to be routine. Because routine means nothing new will happen. Let me move on. Isaiah 43 and 18 and 19 says, God says, remember ye not the former things, the things that are gone. Neither consider the things of old, the former things and the things of old. Behold, I will do new things. Praise God. Amen. Now it shall spring forth. Shall you not know it? God wanted Israel to know that he was going to do a new thing. Amen. 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 And God wants to do new things here. Jesus even said, no one puts new wine into old wineskins, or else the new wine will burst the wineskins and be spilled or wasted, and wineskins will be ruined. But Jesus said this, new wine must be put in new wineskins, and both are preserved. Amen. And no one, having drunk old wine, immediately desires new. For he says the old is better. Luke 5, 37 and 39. Now I ain't gonna mess with that. I ain't gonna mess with that. Jesus is talking spiritually. Amen. He's talking spiritually, and what he's saying is new wine has the strength and power to expand whatever it possesses. Oh, God. New wine. The new wine Jesus is talking about is the Holy Spirit. He was trying to tell his disciples and the Pharisees, new wine has come. Praise God. And new wine, amen, needs new room so that when it possesses it, amen, that nothing will be wasted. There will be an expansion, amen, based on the new wine, amen, in a new arena. Amen. In other words, if we are operating in the oldness of ourselves, nothing new will happen until newness comes. We need, amen, newness, new thinking, praise God, new actions, amen, new things to do that God will work with us. Jesus' implication is that the practice of old patterns, old traditions, and old routines do not need assistance. Amen. Amen. I'm teaching now. I'm going to say it again. The old practices of old patterns, old traditions, and old routines, they do not need assistance to do them. Just follow the order. Do what you've been doing. You don't need to read nothing. Do nothing. Just get in line. The church cannot afford to be an assembly line of works. It has to do new things. Doing things over and over is bored. Amen. When you produce boredom, you're not going to excite nobody, because they already know that what you're going to do, amen, down through the calendar year. Oh my God. But if you're going to do new things cannot function in old things, because Jesus says new, and new getting the old is going to expand. The new going to expand and the old, amen, going to burst, and things may be wasted. But if you let new come in, the Holy Spirit can break the boundaries of ourselves. Holy Spirit will stretch our expectations and give new insight of what will happen, new vision of what can happen, and new purpose, amen, in our efforts. And the Holy Spirit will give new one accordness. The news will break the discordness of ourselves. Amen. And the Holy Spirit will bring newness in us so that we can be on one accord. Praise God. Amen. And God wants to get rid of any discords. Amen. When accordness is not present, it just doesn't run right. Let me pause for a minute. I'm talking to mechanics now. When you have four spark plugs and you take one wire off and another wire off and you don't put them back the same place, your mechanics know what's going to happen. You're going to have a shaky motor. It's going to be, it'll run. It'll be shaking. It won't run smooth. It won't run right. And it's the same thing in church. If you out of order, you ain't gonna run right. If you plug in wrong, let me move on. Y'all getting tired of me, I could tell. Amen. Last thing I wanna say is stretch your faith, not your fears. God told Israel, fear not, for you shall not be ashamed. In other words, move forward in your faith, for you will not fail. Amen. Amen. That old song, I won't let you fall. You just lean on me. Do we believe that? Amen. Do we trust the Lord? What I've discovered is that we want to do more than God. What I've discovered is that we won't let God do much of nothing. I'm talking to anybody. Amen. We want to do so much that God just have to sit down somewhere and say, you know, y'all go ahead. We don't let God do nothing. Amen. Amen. And the fear of that is that we won't get recognized, or we won't get credit for it, or we think the church ain't going to move because of this or that. Or, you know, I wonder if we could take a sabbatical as a church. I wonder if we could take, just be still and let God do what God does. Amen. I wonder if we could just come to church and give him praise and thank and go on back home and pray for one another and come back on next Sunday and give him thanks and pray. Just get out of his way and let God have his way. I wonder if we could do that. God. I found out that too much church won't change it, but I found one who can. Hallelujah. God gave Israel a blessed assurance. He says, if you move forward with your faith, you will not be put to shame. Y'all hear me now. Anybody been following the Lord? Oh, you're going to go through your valleys. You're going to struggle, praise God. And you're going to go in floods. You're going to experience floods coming your way. And there will be times of fiery trials in your life, praise God. But if you hold on to God's unchanging hand, if you stay the course, if you be steadfast and immovable, if you keep looking up unto heaven, good God Almighty, won't God bring you out? He won't let you fall if you lean on him, if you trust him. Praise God. God always tells us to rid our fears. Praise God. There's no need to be a scary Christian. Because scary Christians can't encourage nobody. Scared of everything. You can't have
a fervent witness if you afraid of your salvation. Huh? You gotta have power to be a Christian. Yes, indeed. And no need to mislead you. I ain't misleading you. You need power. Praise God. I got saved, but they kept telling me, Kenneth, you need power. You know, when the Lord called me, a preacher came, I'll never forget. He came to my house. He said, congratulations, the Lord has called you to preach the gospel. Yes, sir, yes, sir, you did. Yes, sir, yes, sir. He said, I'm going to tell you one thing. He said, don't go without the Holy Ghost. He couldn't have told me anything any better than that. Hallelujah, somebody. I want to tell you, praise God. Don't be the church without the Holy Ghost. Don't be a Christian without the Holy Ghost. Never mind your works, for your works are not your power. I'm here to tell you, there got to be a divine intervention. The Holy Ghost must come upon you. You're going to be a church. Move out of God's way. Let the Holy Ghost have his way in you. Bible says, fear not. And fear not is used often in the Bible to those who are being used by God. If you are being used by God, God is still telling every believer who's being used by God to fear not. Don't fear. God told Jeremiah, don't you be afraid of them. I'm going to make your head like flint. He says, face them. They ain't going to like it, Jeremiah. But I want you to say what I'm telling you, praise God. Speak my words to them, praise God. Because my words are going to be like fire. Shut up. That's what the church needs. Fire. Good God Almighty. Shut up in you. And so when you get that in you, I say when you get fire in you, you ain't gonna try to act cute. You ain't gonna care about your time. You won't care about other people. Huh? You don't mind what they say about you. When you get fire, shut up in you. Huh? You gotta tell somebody, huh? You gonna run. You're going to tell somebody, you ain't going to worry about you. Praise God. Oh, yeah, I'm finished. Listen, God has not given us a spirit of fear, but a power of love and sound mind. Many of us need the Holy Ghost. Well, Reverend, I got it. Well, good. I'm glad you got it. Now let him use you. Don't use him. You can't use the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost got to use you. If you got him, let him use. If you got him, let him teach. Good God Almighty. If you got him, he'll help you praise God. If you got him, you'll know how to worship him. If you got him, it just won't be on Sunday. Let the Holy Ghost. When we allow God's power to use us, when we allow love to be in us, I ain't talking about no lip service. When we use our godly minds, our faith, when we begin to function in the power of the Lord, fear must disappear. You better have it. You better have faith. I have faith in the name of Jesus. I call that name
throughout the day and even in the midnight hours. Early! In the morning, I call that name. And the reason why I call it, praise God, I know the devil is lurking. I know he's seeking whom he may devour. But when I call that name, hey, he got the backup. He can't come in my territory. He got to stay back because I'm covered by the blood. He can't get past the blood. Oh, my God. Yeah, I'm gonna finish. Listen. Stretch your faith to trust God's word, God's promises, God's provision. Trust God's power. You can't do nothing no how. Praise God. Not without God. And so we might as well trust him. Amen. Stretch yourself beyond yourself. Stretch your what do you expect from God? It's time to stretch yourself, Saint Stephen. It's time to stretch who you are. You've been told who you are. They told me who you are. I believe it. I see it. Yes, we can be better. We can do better. We can come better. You will not grow a church if you don't show up yourself. Yeah. Stretch yourselves. Get out of your patterns and your molds of what you think works. God is at work. I see it. I saw it yesterday. I love Saint Stephen. I don't care what you say about me. You can't hurt me. Sticks and stones may break my bones. Words have never hurt me. Oh yeah, I've been called some things since I've been here. But if I came to please you, I need to go home. I came to please God. It's time to stretch yourself. Hey! Stretch your power to reach your potential. Stop limiting God in you. Let God's power stretch out in you so you can reach your potential. Stretch your strength to overcome your struggles. You need to be stronger so you can say what you need to say and do what you need to do and stop allowing struggles within yourself to prevent your blessings. Grow up. Stretch your love to reach God's level of it. Stretch your hope so that God can help you be who he has called you to be. Stretch your spirit to spread the salvation in you. Praise God. Tell somebody what the Lord has done. Stretch your holy hands toward heaven to praise God with your hallelujahs. Don't be ashamed. Apostle Paul says, I'm not ashamed. I'm not ashamed. I'm not ashamed. I'm not ashamed of the gospel. I'm not ashamed. I'm not ashamed. Too many shy Christians in the church. Amen. The Bible says, amen. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Don't be ashamed to praise him. Amen. One day you're going to wish you had praise. You don't praise him. Praise God. I'm not ashamed of the gospel, for it is the power of God It's the power of God to everyone who believes. Amen. Don't be ashamed. Be St. Stephen. Be better. Do better. Amen. Stop all that yapping. Get to thinking. Get to your better. Slow down the ineffectiveness, the unproductive. Put it aside for a minute. And say to yourself, what can we do better? Because see, the devil good at deceiving. I got to go. But he can make you think you're doing all right and keep you from your real blessings. Y'all got to sing me another song. That's, if you do, I don't care which one you do, but that last one sounds so good to me. I want to hear the children sing. And y'all please do that. Y'all select anyone you want. But as they prepare themselves to sing, just listen. Just listen. Amen. And then we'll pray.
This is a lot of mine.
Thank you, children. Amen, amen, amen. Thank you, thank you. We want to offer an opportunity for those who wish to join this church, St. Stephen. We offer that opportunity to you. If you're not a member of a church and you're looking for one, you have found it, amen, here at St. Stephen. If there's anybody who wants to confess the Lord and receive the Lord as their Savior today, you have not confessed Him publicly, you have not receive Him in your heart, you believe, we offer you that opportunity right now. You may come to this altar, or you may stand where you are. God can reach you. Amen. Those that are viewing have the same opportunity to do so. With that in mind, let us pray. Father, we praise you for being the kind of God you are. You have shown us who you are in so many ways, yet you're still unidentifiable. For you transcend our thoughts, our imaginations, our wonders about you. You're the kind of God that cannot be contained by mere efforts of humankind. But you transcends everything, and all is beneath you. We look to the hills from whence cometh our help, for our help comes from the God who made heaven and earth. Yes, Lord, we have discovered that there is none like you. You're the God that is ever present, the God that is present in the time of trouble. You're the God that condescends to our level of living to speak, touch, move, heal, and deliver us. We thank you. You're the God that informs us, warns us. You're the God that helps us when we can't even help ourselves. Thank you. You're the God that heals when doctors are puzzled. Nurses have been worn out. You're the God that heals. You know our hurts and our pains, our frustrations and our aggravations, our anxieties, our fears, our doubts. You know all about us. Help us, Lord, to have enough courage to trust you with our lives more and more. That you can strengthen our weaknesses. Help us, Lord God, to stretch our expectation of you and of our own selves. Remove the limitations and the preventions that keeps us from your blessings. Give us hope today. Give us what we need, Lord, more than we know ourselves. You are able to provide. And Lord, help us not to just be churchy. Help us not to be religious. We're living in some serious times. We don't know if we'll make it through this day. Nonetheless, if tomorrow will come, we're living in serious times. Lord, bless these beautiful children. Lord, they're back in school, and Lord, they need help, and you need your presence, and they need your power, they need your protection. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, go with them everywhere they go, Lord, throughout the school year. Oh God, help them to expand their expectations as well, even in school. We pray, God, for the administrations of every school, college, every institution of learning. We pray for protection for them, Lord. The devil is seeking whom he may devour. Oh God, he has people working for him. And we rebuke them and we plead the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ against them. In the name of Jesus, we decree and declare today that no weapon formed against the schools, no weapon formed against the children, hallelujah, no weapon formed against the administration, oh God, shall prevail in the name of Jesus. And then, Lord, no weapon formed against this church and every church. You said, upon this rock I will build my church, my church, my church. Help us to know who church it is. Hallelujah. We'll build my church and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. We believe it. We trust it. We're functioning by it. We're operating by it. And Lord, remove our fear. Help us to walk by faith. Hear our prayers today. We pray for those that are sick and suffering among us, those at home, those that are in institutions of care, those that don't know you, those that are living on the streets and under the trees and on the bridges and, Lord, out in the woods, wherever, those that are hungry and those that need clothes and those that need love, oh God, have mercy, oh God. Those that need deliverance right now, you can go there, wherever they are. Hear our prayers today. Hear our prayers. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Oh God, thank God for this day. Thank God for these children and Katrina and Miss Carter and all that have been involved today. God bless you. Amen. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful program. Amen. There is the silver pans today, or y'all know what that is for today. And we ask that you give for this time of receiving, amen, from the Lord. Amen. Let me say this and then we'll go. Our charge conference, St. Stephen, for this year will be September 29th. That's a Sunday. I think I got that date right. The 29th. Wait a minute. Might be the 26th, I believe it is. Y'all check it. It's the fourth Sunday in September. Let me say it that way. At 2 o'clock. Fourth Sunday in September at 2 o'clock. Is it the 24th? Thank you. 24th. September 24th. Thank y'all. Amen. I got three calendars. I don't look at none of them. Amen. September 24th, 2 o'clock. I want to meet with the administration, the administrative board, all of the trustees, and all of the PPRC committees on Saturday, the first Sunday in September. I know first Saturday in September. Isn't that September 1st? Y'all look at them calendars again. September 2nd, I want to meet with us, 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock, whatever good for y'all. 6 o'clock, first September 2nd, amen, amen. September 2nd at 6 o'clock, I want to meet with the administrative board, the trustee committee, PPRC committee, amen, amen. I'm going to talk with the nominating committee. Amen. I'm going to give Sister Abram a number. And I'm going to give her the names if she don't know them. I'll give her the name. And she's going to call y'all. Give y'all these numbers to call. And we want to meet Saturday, 11 o'clock, on via teleconference. Amen. So I'm going to give this to Ms. Abram, and she's going to be contacting y'all and giving y'all numbers and a code to call Saturday coming, 11 o'clock. Nominating committee. We don't have much time, but we want to start now figuring out what we need to figure out. All right. Enough of that. Visitors. Okay, are there any visitors? Any visitors? Praise the Lord. God bless you and all your children, grandchildren. God bless all of you. Amen. Best church in the world. See there? See in Steve? See? I'm trying to tell you something. Amen. Amen. Are there any other visitors today? God bless you. Amen. Thank God for all of you again. Thank God for this service of the soldiers of the Lord. Amen. 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 And for all the leadership today and all these children and the young ones, the little ones. Yeah. Amen. And which one of them did the tithe and the offering? Which one of them? She did it. Okay. Yeah, you did a fine job, sister. All of y'all did. The prayers. Thank y'all. I'm telling you, y'all just, God, I know we got to go, but I just need to say that kind of thing. Praise the Lord. Did a fantastic job. Yeah, yeah. Yes, Miss Ruthel Johnson. She's a visitor. Hmm.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you, Ms. Johnson. I'm so sorry that happened to you, and thank God it was not worst. Much more could have happened. So, with that in mind, let us take our time and get out of the parking lot. Amen. The food ain't going nowhere. Take your time. Watch what you're doing. Let's not have an accident on this parking ground. Let's be careful. Take your time. Watch what you're doing. Amen. We're going to continue to pray for you, Sister Johnson, and thank God that you had your head checked. Bless you. Amen. All right. I think we're good to go. And amen. Let us stand. Church, amen. Unto him who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or according to the power that worketh in us, who is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before his presence with exceeding joy, unto him be glory and majesty and power. May God bless your going and your coming from this time forth, even forevermore. May he cause his face to shine upon you. May he hear your prayers in the midnight hours, the wee hours of the morning. May he bless your home, your children, and your grandchildren. May he bless your neighbor and your neighbor's children. Keep us, God, from every evil. Deliver us. Remain with us until we meet again. Now with uplifted voices, 3-4, amen. God bless you.